Hi, welcome to Big Data Analytics tutorial. In this video, I will discuss linear regression numerical example with multiple independent variables. So to demonstrate, I will be considering one example where we will be having one dependent variable and multiple number of independent variables in this case. There is another possibility, like we can have one dependent variable and one independent variable. That video link can be found in the description. If you want to watch, you can watch that particular video to understand how can we use a linear regression model for one dependent and one independent variable. Now, in this case, I want to use a multiple number of independent variable. So here the problem definition says that predict the value of y given x1 and x2. So the meaning of this one is y is dependent variable, and x1 and x2 are independent variables. So given the value of x1 and x2, we should calculate the value of y here. So that is what the meaning of this particular problem definition is all about. Now, how many instances are given to us? There are 5 instances are given to us. Using this particular 5 instances, we need to model and then use that particular model to find the value of y given x1 and x2. The 6th example is the testing example, where the x1 and x2 are given to us, that is 3 and 2. We need to predict the value of y. Okay, so this is what actually the problem definition. Now, if you want to model the regression equation for multiple number of independent variable, we need to use some equations. So what we need to do here is we need to create a model. The model looks here we have the regression equation with what we can say that more than one independent variable. Here we have k independent variable, so the equation will look like y is equivalent to beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 plus beta k xk plus epsilon. Here beta 0 is a y intercept, and beta 1, beta 2, beta k are the coefficients of x1, x2 and xk, and epsilon is random error. For our example, we have only 2 independent variable, so the equation should look something like this: y is equivalent to beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 plus epsilon. Okay, but epsilon random error I will not be considering for this demonstration. So the final equation should look like this: y is equivalent to beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2. So we need to calculate the value of beta 0, beta 1, beta 2. So that is what actually we need to calculate. In my demonstration, I will be considering this one as A. So that is the intercept. B1 and B2 I need to calculate. So if you want to calculate these things, we need to have some equations. So that is the first one is to calculate the intercept. That is, as I said earlier, y is equivalent to A plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2. That is the equation. So A is the intercept. So if you want to calculate the intercept, we need to use this equation. That is nothing but y bar, that is nothing but the mean of y minus beta 1 x1 bar, that is the mean of x1. Beta 1 we are going to calculate it here, minus beta 2 x2 bar. X2 bar is the mean of x2 and beta 2 is the coefficient of x2. So that is what the variable. So if you want to calculate the intercept, we need the mean of x1, mean of x2 and the mean of y. And we need to have the coefficients of x1 and x2. Okay, now the question is how to calculate the coefficients of x1 and x2. That is, we can calculate the coefficient of x1 and x2, that is b1 and b2, with this equation. Here we are using the equation b1 is equivalent to summation of x2 square minus summation of x1y minus summation of x1 x2 summation of x2y divided by summation of x1 square summation of x2 square minus summation of x1 x2 bracket square. So the denominator is same in both the cases. Wherever there is x2, we need to put x1, that is x2 square, x1 square here. x1y, it should be x2y. Here x1, x2 remains same. Here x2y will change to x1y here. So this is how actually we can calculate the value of b1 and b2. But if you look at this particular equation, everything on the right hand side, we have used two variables, that is x1 and x2, both the independent variables we have used. But these things, if you'll notice here, we have written all these things in the form of what we can say that the lowercase letters. Okay, So, but we cannot directly calculate these or use these particular things in our equation. So, this is not actually the normal x2. It is the variance with respect to x2. This is the variance with respect to x1. So, that is the reason we need to calculate what is summation of x2 square, what is summation of x1, y and so on. So, this particular terms we need to calculate. So, totally how many things we need to calculate? Summation of x2 square we need to calculate. Summation of x1, y we need to calculate. Summation of x1, x2 we need to calculate. Summation of x2, y we need to calculate. And when it comes to here, we need to calculate summation of x1 square. X2, y is already calculated here. X1, x2 is already calculated. X1, y is calculated here. So, totally we need to calculate 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 terms we need to calculate. Okay, so to calculate these terms, these are, as I said earlier, these are the variance with respect to independent variables. So, if you want to calculate them, we need to use these equations. So, summation of x1 square is always equivalent to summation of x1, x1. That is nothing but the main variable, x1, x1. X1 square, so can be written as x1, x1 minus summation of x1, that is the first variable, multiplied by summation of x1, that is the second variable, divided by n, that is the number of examples. Similar to that, summation of x2 square is equivalent to summation of x2 into x2 minus summation of first variable multiplied by summation of second variable divided by n. With the same note, we need x1y, summation of x1y, summation of x1 multiplied by y minus summation of x1, that is the first variable, summation of y, that is the second variable, divided by n. Summation of x2y is equivalent to summation of x2 into y, summation of x2 first variable, summation of y second variable, divided by n. Summation of x1, x2, summation of x1 into x2 minus summation of x1, that's the first variable, summation of x2, that's the second variable, divided by n. Using this equation, we can easily calculate these particular 5 variables. So, once you calculate it, we can put those things over here, we will get the value of b1 and b2. So, first we calculate these things. If you want to calculate these things, we need these things. Okay, so we need the summation of x1, x1. Summation of x1 is needed for us. Summation of x2, x2 is needed for us. Summation of x2 is needed for us. And summation of x1, y, summation of x2, y. These are the things needed to us. So, what we do is, using this particular given data set, we calculate all these things. What is required? Once again, summation of x1, summation of x2, summation of x1, x1, summation of x2, x2, summation of x1, y, summation of x2, y. All these things are needed. So, we'll try to put all those things in this particular equation or a table. So, these are 5 examples are given to us. Y is given to us. X1 is given to us, X2 is given to us. So, first we calculate summation of Y, summation of X1, summation of X2. Already we have these things, we calculated directly. Now, we calculate X1, X1, that is X1 into X1, 3 into 3 is 9, 4 into 4 is 16 and so on. So, we calculate this particular column. So, once you get this thing, we can calculate the summation of X1, X1. Next, we calculate X2, X2, that is 8 into 8, 64, 5 into 5, 25 and so on. So, once you calculate this column, that is x2, x2, we calculate the summation of x2, x2. That is the addition of all these things. And finally, we calculate x1 into x2. That is the one more thing is required for us. 3 into 8 is 28, 24. 4 into 5 is 20. 5 into 7 is 35. 6 into 3 is 18. 2 into 1 is 2. So, once you calculate it, calculate the sum. That is nothing but summation of x1, x1. Now, we need x1, y. That is x1, y. And then we need x2y. Similarly, we can calculate those two things also. And then we find the summation terms. So, once you get this part of thing, put these particular values in these equations. Okay. So, you will get these particular 5 terms. So, that is what has been done over here. So, if you put those particular values, whatever we have calculated in this table, you will get summation of x1 square is equivalent to 10. Summation of x2 square is equivalent to 32.8. Summation of x1y is equivalent to 17.8. Summation of x2y is equivalent to minus 48. Summation of x1y1 is equivalent to 3. So, once you get these particular terms, you need to go back to these equations. That's the actual equations. B1, B2 and then A. We have these particular terms calculated. Put those values here. You will get B1, B2 and then you will get the value of A here. So, that is what has been done here. So, this is the actual equation. So, summation of x2 square is calculated, put it over here. Summation of x1y is calculated, put that value here. And similarly, put the all the values, you will get the value of b1 as 2.28. Okay, similar to that, what we need to do here is, we need to calculate the value of b2. Again, here what we need to do here is, we need to put the values we have already calculated previously. That is summation of x1 square is calculated here. What is that? 10. summation of x to y, we need that particular value. Summation of x to y is equal to what? Minus 48. Put it over here. That's minus 48. Summation of x1, x2, we have already calculated it. What is the value? That is 3. Put that particular value here. Do the same thing for all the variables and you will get the value of b2, that is equivalent to minus 1.67 in this case. So once you get b1 and b2, we can calculate the value of intercept, that is nothing but a here. A is equivalent to what? Y bar. Y bar is nothing but a mean of y minus beta 1 x1, that is x1 bar, again mean of x1 minus beta 2 x2 bar. So y bar, how to calculate? Summation of y divided by the number of examples. Summation of y is equivalent to how much? 19.5 divided by number of examples, that is 5. So 19.5 divided by 5. So that is what the thing here. Now beta 1 is equivalent to 2.28 multiplied by x1 bar. X1 bar is nothing but what? Mean of x1. So first we need to calculate the sum of x1, that is equivalent to 20 here, divided by 5, that is nothing but a mean of x1. Similar to that, b2 x2 bar, b2 we know that value, put it over here, multiplied by x2 bar. X2 is sum of x2 is 24, we have calculated already, divided by 5. So 24 you can find it here. So 24 is the sum of x2. So put it here, divided by 5, that is nothing but a mean of x2. So solve this equation, you will get 2.796, that is the value of a, that is nothing but a intercept. Now we got the intercept, we got the coefficient of x1, we got the coefficient of x2. Now the final equation is equivalent to, that is y is equivalent to the intercept, that is a 2.796 plus coefficient of x1, that is 2.28, that is 2.28 x1 minus y minus, because we got this coefficient of x2 is equivalent to minus 1.67. So minus 1.67 multiplied by x2. So this is the final equation or the model for multiple linear regression for a given data set. In this case, we have two independent variable and one dependent variable. X1 and x2 are independent variable and y is a dependent variable. Now what is given in our problem definition is, we have given the independent variable values, that is x1 is given to us is 3 and y, x2 value is given to us is 2. We need to predict the value of y. So we need to put this particular values here, that's x1 and x2. We get the value of y here. So y is equivalent to 2.796 plus 2.28 multiplied by 3, that is x1, minus 1.67 into 2, that is x2. We'll get the value of y, that is equivalent to 6.296. So this is what the value of dependent variable given the independent variable x1 and x2 as 3 and 2 respectively. So this is how what we can do is we can solve the linear regression with multiple number of independent variables. This is the most comprehensive way of solving this particular problem. I hope this particular concept is clear. If you like the video, do like and share with your friends. Press the subscribe button for more videos. Press the bell icon for regular updates. Thank you for watching.